the modification of nucleosome, I can say in major way. Now, genomic imprinting is, you know, imprinting term, if you see this term imprinting, it means marking something. It is marking something. So we have we have a father origin, let's say we have a, you know, we have a set of chromosomes, one from father, one from mother, we all know that, and mother, right? So you see that father or mother, whatever we have the same set of chromosomes, so the genes are more or less the same. All these cases, maximum cases same, some nucleotide differences may present, but they are same. Now, what happens in imprinting case, some of those genes are marked to express only from one parent. They are marked to be expressed for only from one parent, not the other. For example, a gene X, let's carry gene X, that gene X is present both in father as well as in mother chromosome. Or gene chromosome. Now this X chromosome, this gene X is marked to be expressed only from mother but not from father. So remember, so once we get that chromosome, let's say here in this male, so this is an example given here actually. Say this is about the IGF. Insulin-like growth factor receptor. This insulin-like growth factor receptor is very, very important for the chemical signaling in insulin. Okay. So see, we have two scenarios. One is IGF-2. Another one is IGF-2-. IGF-2- means this is not expressing. I mean, minus means this gene will be not expressed. And plus means it will be expressed, right? So it is a marking. See, the marking is provided by this coloration. The blue dot marked to be expressed, red dot marked to be not expressed. So say in the mother's genotype, the mother have two genes, two set in all these cases. IGF-2-, IGF-2-. So it is denoted that this IGF-2 should not be expressed from any female cell. IGF-2 gene should not be expressed from any female cell. It should only and only be expressed from the male cell. Only expression from the male cell. This is the marking. This is the imprinting. So, if we get a mother whose genotype is IGF-2-, IGF-2-, it should be. Father's genotype IGF-2, IGF-2. Here. Okay. The marking should be done in the later stages during the gametogenesis, remember. So say it is IGF-2, I must tell you this growth factor, right? This is a growth factor receptor. And this growth factor receptor is important for also say chemical signaling process and also for the height. Let's say for the height we say. So say IGF-2 means it will be a normal height, normal. IGF-2- means it will be a dwarf height. Which one you want me to repeat? After the arrow mark. Okay, I am explaining this image. Okay, that is, we have, let's say, the idea of genomic imprinting will only occur during the gametogenesis process. Okay, the formation of gametes. So here, IGF-2, if IGF-2 is present, that means the offspring will be of normal height. IGF-2- means the offspring will be dwarf. Okay. So now if you look here, that father's genotype is IGF-2, IGF-2, mother's is IGF-2-, all this case. So if you have a cross here, as we'll get IGF-2, IGF-2-. Now in this case, we'll get one copy IGF-2 from father and IGF-2- from mother. So we'll get this. But as we get one IGF-2, the offspring is normal here. Why? Because once we get IGF-2 and IGF-2-, we get both these things from father and mother. Now the offspring, the marking should be done. And the marking is, we get the gene, but it depends on whether we express that gene or not. if we get that gene from father, whatever gene we get from the father, only we express that. But the gene that we get from mother will not express that. Remember, this is the scenario. Let's say this is my case, this is my cell in my body. It's denoted, it's marked that the gene that you get from your father, you should express that. But the gene you should not get your, you should, I mean, you get your, from your mother, you should not express that. So the gene IGF2 minus, I get it from mother, so I will not express this gene. But I get the IGF2 from father, so I will express that gene. So, as IGF2 is expressed, you know, IGF2 gives us height, normal height. So the cell will be of normal height, the offspring will be of normal height. Similar case, let's say the mother's genotype is IGF2 normal. Father is IGF2 minus. We get both of them, IGF2 minus. Now the imprinting situation, again, the question is, the gene that I got from the father, I should express that, but from the mother should not express. The gene I get from the mother is IGF2, normal copy, but imprinting says we should not express that. We get it from father, IGF2 minus, imprinting says I should express that. So I will express IGF2 minus instead of IGF2. So height will be dwarf. Height will be shorter. Got it? Yeah, why it is not expressed? It is the condition in the cell, it is provided. That is the idea of genomic imprinting. This is the phenomena. In cell, it was observed, sometimes some genes should be expressed from mother origin, some genes should be expressed from father origin. It varies in certain cases, in certain processes in cell. So it is marked. That's why it's marked. In this case, we should express this only from father, not from the mother. Even if we get the good copy from mother, but still we'll not express it. We get a faulty copy from father, but still will express because it is marked, right? And it will generate the dwarf offspring here. Now, how this process works? See, the mechanism of this genomic imprinting occurs again in three different stages. One is the induction, second one is the maintenance, third is the to the next generation. So, say at the very beginning, what happens in the zygote level? Egg. Let's say this is the egg contains IGF2 minus and sperm contain IGF2 normally, okay. Now what happens in this case? Sperm donates the nucleus, IGF2 is there. So, in both this case, same thing. IGF2 is donated by the sperm in that case. IGF2 is expressed because it is from the father. Remember, both the case, the IGF2 is from sperm, so it is from the father origin. So, both the offspring will express the IGF2 from the father origin. So the height of the offspring will be normal. So both of them, the height is normal, normal height here. Okay, the height is of normal. Now the important step, this is the induction. Now there should be the maintenance of that thing. How it will happen? Now let's say among these two individuals, this one is a female and this is a male. This is a female, this is male. So the female, remember, so whatever gene transferred to the female, we know what gene will transfer to the female, will transfer the silenced gene, silenced allele to the female, and will only transfer the transcribed allele to the male gametes. So to produce the female gametes or egg, we produce everything with the IGF2 minus. But to produce the sperm, we produce everything with IGF2 only. So here, as it is a female, what will we do? We only transfer this IGF2 minus to the gametes, to the egg. On the other hand, we only transfer IGF2 to the sperm nucleus. So all the generation of the sperm get IGF2, all the egg gets IGF2 minus. Now the exact molecular mechanism behind this process. It's kind of complicated, so I want you to be with me slowly. If you get any problem understanding, just pause me once and ask. The mechanism here is, it's a single mechanism though. The idea behind it is the ICR. It's called imprinting control region. Imprinting control region that is present in both, in male, female, both of the cases. And this ICR is a domain which can be methylated, right? So you can add methyl group there. And this ICR region is filled with a repetitive sequence called CTC, I mean cytosine, thymine, cytosine, CTC, repeat CTC sequences. So that's why we call it a CTC center. And ICR is a one of the part of this CTC center. Okay, and we know this ICR, left and right hand side, the upstream and downstream of both of this, we have IGF2 here and we have H19, very close to each other in two different regions, but we have IGF2 and H19. Why H19? I am telling you. We have seen an example of IGF2 and this is a true example for mammals. IGF2 as well as H19, they are controlled by the same element of ICR. That's why they are given here. Though the idea of expression of H19O1, what is the function of H19, is not clear yet, but the function of IGF2 is very much clear. The idea here is this ICR region is present. It can be methylated. And there are protein called CTC binding factor. CTC binding factor. CTC binding factor can bind to the CTC region, the CTC component of the DNA here, which is a part of the ICR. So CTC binding factor can bind with the ICR. So if CTC binding factor binds with the ICR, then the DNA methylase, right? Methyl transferase enzyme that is present in DNA that will transfer the methyl group will not be able to interact with the ICR. So the methylation will not be there. So if there is no methylation, the activation of IGF2, the transcription of IGF2 gets halted, because the methylation of ICR is very, very important. Why? Because as the methylation is blocked by CTC binding factor, the CTC binding factor helps in the transcription of H19 mRNA. Now this H19 mRNA produces a protein. That protein inhibits the expression of IGF2. Okay, so no IGF2 here. But assume another situation where CTC binding factor unable to bind with ICR, and when in that case methylation is done. When the methylation is done, then CTC binding factor will not able to bind with the ICR region. As a result, H19 production is halted. And some other activator proteins will interact with this methylated component along with the promoter of IGF2 to transcribe IGF and then to produce the IGF protein. So, the take home message, if ICR gets methylated, IGF2 will be expressed. But if ICR is non-methylated, blocked by CTC, there will be IGF2 minus, no expression. So in females, this scenario is going on, in males, this way going on. So see the final event, that is the maintenance of genomic imprint. And if you look at the maintenance here, somatic cell, two different chromosome set, right? One from father, one from mother, clearly. This is a zygote, and this zygote is forming female. This zygote is finally making a female individual. So the maintenance will be there. The somatic cell division will occur the same way. So all the somatic cell originated from the parent cell, from this maternal cell here, all the cells, they contain methylation at the very first place, because if there is a methylation of the IGF2 group here, so the methylation will be present in all these cases. But during the time of gametogenesis, production of gamete, they will erase all the methylation thing. So demethylation takes place and they will make those chromosomes clear without any methylation, no methylation. From there, if they want to produce egg, no methylation should be done, because for the production of egg, we should have a IGF2 minus. Remember, in the IGF2 minus, we should not have a methylation. So all the chromosomes that will be present here will not get any methylation at all, because they are producing egg. But why ICR is not methylated in the case of maternal chromosome? Is it a matter of chance? No, it's not a matter of chance. It's a kind of randomized event. It depends on the imprinting process. You know, it's again, imprinting is also carried out from one generation to another generation. That's what we are seeing. So the imprinting says that if it is a male, I mean, if it is going to produce sperm, if it's a male individual, it is going to produce sperm, not egg. So do it to the way of methylation so that we can carry that IGF expression, not silencing. If it is want to produce any, if it is trying to produce a female gamete, that is the egg, in that case, it will go on the female way, that to silence IGF2. And the way to silence this is to not go for methylation. If you want to activate it, then it will go for the methylation. Imprinting implies this rule that we should express this IGF2 from male, not from female anymore. For keeping that happening, that's why it's called the maintenance. To maintain this strategy throughout the generation, throughout the step, this process is done. And the erasure is there, that is the demethylation. In case of a male gamete production, see, maintenance of normal cells remains the same. But if it needs to produce and mature to produce a sperm cell or a male gamete, in that case, again erasure, right? All the methylated groups are demethylated here in early spermatocyte. Now in the early spermatocyte section, they denote that this is going to be sperm. So we need to put methyl group to make IGF2 activated. Right? For that reason, all the chromosomes that are present there should be methylated. All the chromosomes there should be methylated. Because ultimately those, whatever number of chromosomes are there, they will produce sperm. So every sperm should get a methylated chromosome. Because they should express IGF2. In case of female, none of them are getting any methylation because to ensure that single, because they are making haploid now. 2N number here, now here and N number. So they are making sure that all the egg cells receive a single copy without methylated condition. On the other hand, in case of male gametes, they are observing that they will get single copy and every single copy should be methylated.